The recent Saturday nights may have belonged to the X Factor, Strictly Come Dancing, of course, but there was a time when weekend viewing meant gigantic frog costumes, slippery log contests, water cannons and mud baths. They were just some of the wacky features on the show. It's a knockout.
Jeux en Frontières, hosted oui. There we are, Stuart Hall's in. The host of the programme, and this Christmas is a particularly special one for him. Happy birthday, Stuart, on Christmas Day.
Are you going to mention the number of years?
You can if you wish.
I won't. 80.
80. Oh.
80 years old.
Yeah.
Extraordinary. Now, we're going to have a look at, we're going to have a chat in a moment. We're going to go back in time.
Really?
And yes. Look at some of those wonderful times with Jeux en Frontières.
This is a turn up for the book. Running sideways. Can you get those two buckets? Yes, she can. There he is. He's got hands like frying pans, that fella, and they're seasoned like old leather. Swing it about, right, off it.
John Wood took the inside.
Have you ever seen a town councillor competing in It's a Knockout before? But here he goes, he's got to burst those balloons and stay on course. Two apiece. Fantastic.
I bet there's someone watching that saying,
back.
That was me. That was
yes.
Me. Whenever it was.
I remember them. Dear. I met a guy in Spain last year in the midst of a great mob of people, and I recognised him as Fred Standard from Luton, 1974.
Really?
The human fly from Luton. I hope he's watching this morning.
The human fly from Luton. If he is, I'm sure he'll be in contact.
Absolutely.
That was a terrific show, though, wasn't it? Where did it come from?
But who's they were the fundamental programmes, the domestic programmes. The winner of the domestic heat went then into Europe, where 80 million viewed it live. 30 million in Germany. Just imagine you're there representing Luton and suddenly you're a world star. 80 million people watching. The theatre of the absurd, and I've loved it. I was the Lord of Misrule.
Yeah, and the joy of your broadcasting at that time was that you say you loved it, you just laughed. I mean, just the laughter in that show as you were trying to describe these absurd, these nonsense in front of you.
Yeah, but
it was so infectious.
It was like the custard pie Olympics, where we took people from sort of ordinary lives and that's not a disrespectful term, but made them stars. There they are. Ooh, there you are. You've got Great Britain on your chest, and I've done all the games. I've had more injuries than any of the competitors because I was the sort of tester for all the games.
What, you used to do them before that?
I did them, yes. I've been immersed in vats of foam. I've vaulted over canals full of untreated sewage and all sorts of stuff.
Where was Eddie Waring while you were talking?
I was the official interpreter for Eddie throughout Europe and I never understood a single word.
My personal favourite were all the games that involved a piece of kind of giant elastic tied to your back
like
and had to run forward and try and grab something and get pinged back.
Yeah.
Mine were the big costumes, the ludicrous costumes on a bit of slippery foam. Yes, that's right.
But,
very silly.
I'm now doing Ninja Warrior on Challenge TV. It ought to be on BBC. Yeah. Ninja Warrior is the son of Knockout, but it's more bestial, more cruel, where people actually fall 100 feet into a mud bath. It's fantastic.
Stuart, I worked with you and you were a serious
man. I know,
man.
I remember you in Manchester 20 years ago.
Yes, that's right. But you started it, well, firstly, you wanted to be a racing driver, didn't
that's
you?
Right.
That's right.
Never won a race. I was second, third or fourth. I went down to Crystal Palace to play football. They offered me £20 a week and £10 in the summer. And I said, it won't keep me in tarts and fags. So that was the football career finished, motor racing finished. The only way out was to talk about the sport, and that's what I've done.
And in the football commentary, of course, carries on. You're still working out, Five Live, all the time.
Oh, yes.
And you do have a very special place in football lovers' minds because, I mean, are you given complete free rein? Can you do it any style you like?
You are so unpredictable,
like.
Honestly.
The secret is that it's my non-paying hobby, it's footy, so I can say what I like. I interviewed Mick McCarthy the other day and talked about his sartorial elegance. He didn't understand a word I said, and I can get away with it because I'm not being paid, you see. So I can afford to say to football, it is the greatest entertainment in the world, and I can be off the wall, bizarre, louche, outré, but sweaty song, and say what I like and enjoy myself. Because life is here to be enjoyed. And I say to people, if you're not enjoying your life, get out and do something else. Because we fret and strut our stuff across the stage and then are heard no more. So whilst you're here, extract as much fun as you possibly can.
It's almost like having Simon Callow sat here. You're waxing so lyrical.
But Simon is from the diaphragm, isn't
he's
he?
He's over there listening
so
now.
Simon Callow will come on and give you some proper English, some received pronunciation. Simon, just give me a bellow.
Nothing to bang on. We should have had a kind
did
of a voice.
Why do you get him on with me?
It's lovely to see you. You have not changed a bit in 20 years, and I'm sure you'll be continuing doing this.
You are still as great a fibber as you were 20 years ago.
Such a charmer, isn't
it? You haven't changed.
I feel like I'm imposing on a very private scene here.
Ever so slightly.
Forever and forever farewell. If we shall meet again, then we may smile. If not, this parting were well made. Follow that, Carlo, will you?
He's warming up over there. He's doing his... you're on... Is it Boxing Day? You're doing a commentary on Boxing Day?
No. My birthday is Christmas Day, so I'll be in a stupor, really, okay, with flagons of claret and lots of Bollinger. And I'm not fit to broadcast on Boxing Day, but I'm at the School of Science on the 28th.
It's great to see, and a very happy birthday to you.
Very kind of you to invite me on your sofa, or, as we say in our north, city.
City. It's not bad, this city, is it?
It would
no,
great.
Not
Thank
bad.
You.
Thank you.